Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. Tonight's video is about fragrances that I find to be so unique. I don't have anything else in my own personal collection like the fragrances that I'm going to share with you tonight, nor have I really sniffed anything either in samples or decants that make me think of the particular fragrances that I'm going to share with you. They are for people who are adventurous in their fragrance selections and want to try something that is different from what everyone else is wearing and that people might have a really difficult time pinpointing. Although a few of these, I think people could pick out. So for the most part, these are really different kinds of fragrances. So before we get started, I would love for you to share in the comments a fragrance in your collection or that you have sniffed either by decant or by sample that you think is particularly unique, meaning you have a hard time finding any other fragrance that smells like this one. So take a second to drop that into the comments. I would also like to hear from you about what other kinds of videos you would like to see from me. I have planned so many. I have a million and one ideas for videos, but would really love to hear what you're interested in. Many, many, many moons ago, when I started my channel, I posted a video about odd, strange, and peculiar fragrances, I think was the title of it, which is a bit different than what we're talking about today. If you're interested in seeing something like that, please let me know. So these are fragrances that I may or may not like that I think are really strange and peculiar. And I also have a fragrance layering video, part one and part two, that I have planned out and in my mind. Would you be interested in hearing about fragrance layering? I know there's a lot of videos out there that talk about fragrance layering already. And I also plan to bring you, I hope if you like it, a affordable and hidden gems fragrances video part two. I did a part one like early last spring. Would love to do a part two for you if you're interested. So of the topics that I just mentioned, what interests you most? Okay, let's jump into today's video. So the first one I have talked about on my channel, well, in fact, I've talked about all of these at some point on my channel, but it's an oldie but a goodie, and it is L'Eau de Issey Miyake. This is an original formulation bottle, and you can see how much I love it from the dent in this. What an interesting and unique fragrance. I remember this as being sort of a staple in the late 90s into the early 2000s when it was the most popular, at least among my circles. And I remember this being that fragrance that when I went out with a group of girlfriends, like let's say we were going out to a nightclub or out to dinner or something like that, if someone in the group was wearing this, you were like, okay, she's gonna get all the attention tonight because she smelled so amazing. This is one of those nuclear performers, at least the old formulation, one that reminds you a lot of like the scent of being beachside with some florals, with, if you understand what the note cologne is about, which I just came to understand last year. I had loved it in fragrances for forever, but hadn't quite like pinpointed what the note was that I loved. Cologne is a note that smells a lot like, to me, a concentrated watermelon fragrance. Like if watermelon, the fruit, had a fragrance that was an extrait version, it might be what this smells like. And cologne also smells beachy. It smells like ocean air, ocean water, that like saltiness. So imagine somewhere between watermelon and like salty ocean air or both combined. That's what this smells like. Yes, there are other notes in here. Obviously, like there's rose and there's melon. And I think there's freesia as well, which is a note that's a little bit strange for me. But what I get mostly out of this, yes, I get some florals, but I get that strong cologne note, a la Eternity by Calvin Klein, except this is even more unique. Eternity almost made it onto this list because it's equally as unique. It's so different. And when people are wearing it, you know that person has on Eternity for sure. Kind of like when people are wearing Light Blue by Dolce & Gabbana, you know. That is light blue. This is the same thing. L'eau de Ise, this is a very unique fragrance. When people are wearing this, you know, I think it is quite beautiful. It can be overpowering. I think it's described as a floral aquatic or an aquatic floral. I don't know. Yes, it has like a wateriness to it, but it is still a very strong fragrance and has like a 90s DNA through and through. One of the most beautiful creations of the 90s, if you ask me, and worth getting an original formulation if you can find it. Next is a fragrance that I just cannot get enough of. I want to wear it very, very much as the spring and the summer roll in, and I have enjoyed it thus far. It's one of my favorite newer houses, Scents of Wood. Oh my goodness, if you're not familiar with this house, and if you like woody
You
scents,
must
check this house out. I would suggest getting a sampler set. The one that I am talking about that is especially unique, and a lot of them are super unique, by the way, so this really had to make the cut. It's cedar in acacia. I go goo goo over this, goo goo gaga, bananas, bonkers. I flip over this. There's something so fresh, so herbaceous. I always struggle. Is it herbaceous or herbal or herbally? Whatever. There's some like herbs and spices in here, some ginger, cedar. There's this like freshness, there's this fresh woodiness. It leans slightly masculine, but not enough to be like off-putting if you like feminine fragrances. I don't know. This is like the most elevated spa smell ever, ever, ever with hints of cedar. I don't know what acacia smells like. I can't say. I don't know. But whatever is in this for me is just like magical. I like those medicinal kinds of scents. They really do it for me. They draw my attention when they have kitchen spices like coriander. I don't think this has coriander, but it reminds me a little bit of Coriandra by Jean Couturier. But anyway, this is to me one of the more unique fragrances from Scents of Wood, and I love all of them. I haven't found a stinker in that house. There have been a couple I haven't been like super crazy enough to buy a bottle, but we have, I think, four bottles of this and several samples and travel sprays as well, in addition to the full-size bottles. And oh my goodness, fabulous. We have for you next the one and only Womanity. This is a very polarizing fragrance, which is why I just laugh like a hyena, like I don't have any sense. Some people really hate this and they think it smells like fish. I don't get any fish in this at all. I'm always respectful of what people feel like they pick up in fragrances. I don't get any fish. This is a fig and fig leaf and a caviar scent. I don't know what caviar smells like. Have you had caviar? Because to me, it really doesn't smell like much except maybe like slightly salty water. This fragrance, you know, you have to appreciate weirdo scents to really like this. And first of all, let's talk about the bottle. The bottle is this spectacular pink pillar with the Mad Max Beyond Thunderdome theme here, and I always say that, okay, it looks like the thugs from Mad Max rounded up some scrap metal from a leftover city, like a city that had crumbled, and put together an outfit. That's what this reminds me of. I really enjoy this fragrance when I wear it. It warms up quite nicely on the skin. You do get fig. You get like what would be like a woody, dry coconut scent that's really not listed as a note in here, but I get that. And I do get like this salty sea air kind of smell. So imagine yourself by an ocean and imagine like the sweet, almost rotten fruit smell of an overripe fig in this with some saltiness and some sweetness at the same time. Very, very peculiar fragrance. I know it looks like I haven't used this much, but I have worn this a handful of times now and I really enjoy it. It's one that I don't mind like overspraying because I don't find it cloying or overpowering or anything like that. It's got this really cool ring that sits on top of the atomizer like that. So the bottle for sure is one of the most unique. Next up is the incomparable Casbah by Robert Piguet. This is one of the most beautiful incense fragrances I have ever laid my nose on. It smells straight up like the incense that's coming out of a censer. I always get tripped up on that word, but I remembered this time, a censer in a church, what the officials, the priests and so forth are swinging up and down the aisles that are metal and have smoked incense or smoking incense in them. So beautiful. I love most about this fragrance that it has like a greenness at the top, along with like the spices and the herbs that are in this. I have a feeling there's a lot in this that's not listed. And of course, it smells like incense. And then it has a woodiness to it that makes it super, super duper unique. I just adore this. I've smelled a lot of incense fragrances, but have not come across anything like Casbah by Robert Piguet. Now, let's talk about a fragrance that I really have to be in the mood to wear because it's that unique and that particular. It is Beach Hut by Amouage. So let's talk about Amouage for a quick second. I have two from the line and I have some decants of most of the female Amouage fragrances, not all. And I find them especially challenging. These are really unique and particular fragrances that if you don't understand the Amouage DNA, if you haven't sampled the house, you might be in for a very strange surprise when you order a lot of these. They are very, very strong fragrances. They all have this similar, like woody for the most part, not all. A lot of them have this woody, like almost like medicinal base to them, upon which all of the fragrances are built for the most part, not all. So this one here, first of all, I love the Amouage bottles. Can we just take a second to appreciate how gorgeous these are? This fragrance gives a woody female fragrance like a whole new vibe and flavor. It's called Beach Hut, so yes, it reminds me of being inside a beach hut that was constructed purely of like leftover palm materials. Like if we were on Survivor, do we like Survivor? Oh, wait, oh, wait, oh, wait, oh. Okay, stop. Do you like the Survivor theme song? I love it. I play it over and over in my head. If we were inside a Survivor self-made hut, it would smell something like this. This is a really difficult to describe fragrance for me. It has a strong woodiness to it, a la a fragrance that I recently described that I picked up called Knock on Wood from Tory Burch. It has something similar to that in that it smells strongly like pencil shavings or like when my husband, when he turns wood for a hobby, like he makes wood bowls. The shavings that come off of that and drop to the floor as he's working on his, I think it's called a lathe, that those shavings smell a lot like this with a touch of a medicinal thing. There's also a very slight faint greenness in this that isn't listed anywhere in the notes. This is supposed to have a floral in it. A lang-a-lang is listed on FragranceNet. I don't know that I get any heavy florals in this. I will say this is one that develops nicely on the skin and really sort of meshes in with your skin chemistry in a beautiful way to give you this sense that like you're laying in a hammock on the beach. Of course, the fact that it's called Beach Hut completely influences this impression, but you're surrounded by woods that are heating up from the sun. And they have a lot of moisture in them. Imagine when like woods emit their moisture, trees, bark, fallen limbs, as they begin to heat up from the sun's rays and decompose, they give off an earthy smell that is something like Beach Hut. That's how I can best describe it. And I like it. I'm here for it. We come next to a fragrance that took me a while to fall in love with. When I first got it as a travel spray, I was like, woo! Thank God I didn't buy a full bottle of this. And as I played with it more, I realized I think I do like this. And then when I purchased the full bottle and really did like a full-on few days of wear on this, I was like, yeah, this is a really unique, interesting fragrance that I'm super glad to have in my collection, especially because it is discontinued. It is Atelier Cologne Café Tuberosa. So this fragrance, does it have a lot of tuberose in it? Not really. There's like a faint hint of it. What I get mostly in this is a very, very strong coffee, almost like espresso note at the beginning. It's intolerable when you first spray. You're like, whoo, I don't know that I can get through this, but that goes away super quickly. And you're left with this gorgeous, deep, dark, rich, decadent coffee note, like of the espresso kind, like the thickest espresso that you can make. Is like this. There's another word for it that I can't remember. When you order a super concentrated small, you know, taza of coffee, that's what this reminds me of. There's some cacao in here as well. So imagine like a dark chocolate with the darkest coffee with some rose sprinkled on top. That would give you a sense of what this smells like. It's very different and unique, and I can't say that I've smelled anything else like this. And I'm here for it now that I appreciate strange fragrances all the more. Speaking of interesting and unique rose fragrances, here's one that I didn't know that I would grow to love. And it's one that you have to spray on your skin and wear for a full day. You have to let it heat up with your body chemistry and other people smell it before you're like, yeah, I think this is a keeper. It is Flora Botanica by Balenciaga. It's certainly gotten a ton of love here on YouTube in the past couple of years. Cute bottle. I should probably get a full one, but what an interesting fragrance. There is a sharpness to this fragrance that if you like only soft and like super girly feminine, you probably won't like this. But if you don't mind a little bit of edge, this has a, what I think is a semi-strong, it's not super prominent, but a semi-strong mint note in it. And it's mostly like a rose dominant fragrance. There's a cannabis note in here that, yes, you can smell, but I would say it plays second fiddle to like this clean, green, rose kind of accord in here that reminds me a lot of like, again, I go back to that spa thing, like imagine eucalyptus and mint and rose and a little hint of cannabis and maybe some other like herbs and minty kinds of notes mixed together would give you a sense of this. It does soften up into this really pretty rose fragrance. Husband loves this on me, which is interesting. I thought he would hate it. He really likes it. And it's just unique. It's different. So if you like a daring scent and don't mind smelling different and maybe non-girly in a minty kind of way, slightly rosy kind of way, check out Flora Botanica. Come next to a fragrance that perhaps people would disagree should be on a unique list, but to me it is because it nails the garden theme so uniquely in a way that I have not smelled any other fragrance to be able to do. And it's Baiser Volé from Cartier. Did I pronounce that right? Baiser Volé. That one, okay? This is a unique white floral fragrance, in my opinion. It's lily heavy, which is interesting because I have a hard time with lily, but I just love this. Love the cigarette lighter kind of look too. This is such a fresh, it's like if you freshly cut grass at the same time that you're in a greenhouse of newly flowering fragrances. No. Of newly flowering plants, and you've had a chance to actually like cut the stems of all of them fresh. They're just fresh. And you have like a dirt smell plus the fresh flowers, plus, I don't know. Ooh, It smells almost like you have a hint of rosemary and a hint of mint. Have you ever like, what am I doing here? Have you ever rubbed your fingers on the leaves of mint or of rosemary? If you combine those two, smash it in here with fresh florals and lilies and a little bit of fresh dirt, like freshly wet earth in a garden. Oh my gosh, this is what you get in here. It is so magnificent that way, if you like that. It does it for me. This is a really unique fragrance. I adore it. I come next to a fragrance that I have talked about several times on my channel, and I think is just incredibly beautiful, unique, and different. Of course, that's the theme of this video. It's Acqua Divina by Bulgari, a house that I have become recently obsessed with. Now, I was obsessed with Bulgari in the early 2000s, turned my nose away from them for a while, and have recently, like in the last year or two, been like, oh my gosh, I'm really into Bulgari fragrances. Again, this fragrance here, first of all, the bottle, it looks like a clam shell or an oyster shell or something like that, and is really super interesting. I call this my poolside picnic fragrance. Yeah, it smells to me like the chemicals from a pool have risen up and mixed with beautiful florals and with citrus and with cleaners, like house cleaner scents, right? Like the clean smells that you would get from the chemicals that you use to clean a home. Imagine all of that like mashed together with some underlying woodiness that is super sophisticated and elegant, and you might get a sense of what this smells like. It's just so different to me. I tell you, when I first purchased this and I found this at Marshall's for like a super bargain, I was like, I'll take a chance. No problem. You only cost $30. I'll add you to cart. Got it home, smelled it, and was like, that's interesting. And more that I tried this, the more I just knew that it was fabulous. So I have put quite a dent in this. You can't see this on camera, but it's down to like here, which is a big deal because this is the majority of the fragrance, right? You get this cap. So for me to have a dent down to here is pretty significant. I find this to be a very elegant fragrance that I would wear to like that power business meeting when I wanted to set myself apart based on a sophisticated fragrance. Acqua Divina, get you some. Next, I bring you a fragrance that I call my meeting in person kind of scent. It's the scent that I would reach for when I'm meeting with colleagues and I'm in a conference room that has an intimate setting, and I don't want to offend people, but I definitely want to smell like myself. I want to smell good, but not have my fragrance speak for me. I want people to hear me and my thoughts, but I also want them to remember that I smelled pleasant. I would go for, and that's why it's so unique. I've never smelled anything like this. It's Skin from Clean. This is the Clean Reserve version. I ran through the regular bottle of this. I just sprayed a little because I wanted to remind myself how fabulous this is. It's interesting when you look at the notes for this. According to Fragrantica, this has praline, it has, hold on, salt, musk, leather, and tonka bean. Yes, I guess when I sit there and analyze and break down the scent that is here, I can pick up most of that. But I can tell you that it just smells like a sweet, musky skin of someone who is freshly showered, but they have warmed up. Their body had their skin has warmed up during the day. Their natural whatever scent, aroma, etc., has started to sort of emanate up from their skin, and it smells kind of sweet and musky, like you want to lean in, almost like a boyfriend t-shirt fragrance kind of a thing. It's in that realm, except it does have this undercarriage, this undergirding of sweetness to it that probably comes from that tonka bean that's in there. And it's lovely. It's faint and it's nice and it's close to the body and it's non-offensive, and I adore it. Hang in there. We have two more fragrances. I'm saving the best for last. Okay, so just hang around. But the next to last is the beautiful, also incomparable, and has made its rounds through YouTube. So maybe it's not that unique, but it feels unique to me. And that is Givenchy Haute Couture. I have the EDP version, and I need to get my hands on the EDT version. I keep thinking, pick it up, Veronica, because people seem to like the EDT more than the EDP. But to me, this is a sweet, fruity raspberry. It has a little bit of tartness from like a citrus note. I think there's an orange or mandarin kind of note in here, but it's a lot of raspberry. And there is, listen, okay, listen, there is like a cigarette ash accord in here that some people are turned off by because it is accompanied by other notes that help it smell good. I think I kind of like that accord in here. There is also pepper and what I feel like is a bit of a leather accord, perhaps because of the sandalwood and other notes in here that combine to give it a little bit of a leathery feel. But I think it's beautiful and I think it's unique and I haven't smelled anything else like this. Then perhaps the most unique fragrance in my collection, hands down, perhaps and hands down go together. Y'all, this is a good one. And you have to be super adventurous to like this. So don't go blind buying this and saying, Veronica said it smells good and I hate it. You can't blame me for this one. Nobile 1942 Shamal. I was introduced to this fragrance by my dear friend Richard Keycott here on YouTube channel. Richard Keycott, check him out. He's so fun. He's so fun to watch, so insightful about fragrances. He introduced me to this, and I knew immediately I had to have a bottle. It smells to me, and I always say this, and I'm sure people are sick of hearing it. They're probably rolling their eyes like in this Robert Downey Jr. meme. Okay, I get it. It smells like recaíto that people use in the Caribbean to spice up stews and any dishes that have like a watery kind of base to them. It's like every amazing kitchen spice all in one. There's supposed to be incense in here. There's supposed to be dates and apple. So if you're someone that does not appreciate fragrances that lean masculine, stay away from this one. It's like just on the other side of masculine. But I just adore this. It's aromatic, it's deep, it's strong. It's beguiling, bewitching, compelling. It draws you in. You want to know about it. It's like that person that you meet that has a fascinating life story, and you want to hang out around a bonfire, drinking wine, hearing their background. That fragrance does this for me. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me and listening to me chat about fragrances that I think are unique and different from anything else I have in my collection. Don't forget to drop in the comments that fragrance in your collection that you think is the most unique and share with all of our fragrance friends here so we can learn from you and each other. Thanks so much, and I will see you in the next video. Take care, my friends.